The discussed studies cover an area of a section of a valley of two small rivers, Milakówka and Wąska, situated at the height of a village named Strużyna in northeastern Poland. The said area of about 700 hectares has been covered with a forest since at least the late 19th century and for a long time. Identification of archaeological heritage within its borders was hindered. In the years 2012 to 2016, a grant of National Program for the Development of Humanities titled Catalogue of Warmia and Mazury Strongholds was implemented under the direction of Professor Zbigniew Kobyliński. As part of the grant, a non-invasive prospection of the discussed area was performed using ALS data. This allowed us to verify the form of range of fortification of own physical form of the formerly known strongholds, Strużyna 21, situated on the edge of the mentioned valley, and also to identify a formerly unknown defensive settlement Strużyna 24, located only 1 kilometer in a straight line from the former. Moreover, we have recorded a number of anthropomorphic features that could not be completely verified on site at the time. The project titled Non-Invasive Identification of Archaeological Heritage in the Area of Strużyna Village was executed in the spring of 2018. The main objective of the project was to verify burrows occurring in the area, yet information on the other features was also successfully obtained, which allowed the researchers to recreate main points of history of this microregion manifested in its landscape. The project was implemented with the contribution of archive research, in which archival maps, source text and data of archaeological sites collected under the project Polish Archaeological Record were used. These data were collected and mapped in GIS database and then compared with ALS data obtained under the project titled ISOC. In the course of ALS data processing, a number of anomalies formed potentially as a result of human activity were determined. These points were verified on site during survey prospection and documented. Moreover, for a single feature, also non-invasive methods were performed using Bartington magnetic gradientometer. The result of the study is a map with marked archaeological sites that can be classified according to their function and chronology. The first group was strongholds. This category involves two sites. Strużyna 24 is a defensive settlement of about 0.4 hectares covering an exposed promontory surrounded from the three sides by a deep valley of a small stream, cut off from the upland by three lines of dikes and moats. During the excavations in 2015, a historical material was obtained based on which it was concluded that the settlement had been inhabited at the turn of Latin A period by people classified as the West Barbaro culture. At present, the dikes and the moats are very difficult to identify, which is only partially due to erosion. They were most likely partially used for agricultural purposes as evidence by small furrows oriented in the east-west direction, which are marks left after the field was plowed. Radiocarbon dating of carbon obtained from subsoils gave a time range of 1328 to 1445 AD. The next stronghold is Strużyna 21, is a two-phase stronghold with a complex stratigraphy with an adjacent settlement outside the walls, covering a total area of about 1.6 hectares. Like Strużyna 24, it covers an exposed promontory and it cut off from the upland by a dike and a mound. The older phase should be linked to the people of the West Balt Barrow culture and dated to Latin C. Thermolumiscence dating identified the period as 310 to 30 BC. This area was again used in the early Middle Ages when in the place of the older settlements the stronghold was erected with fortification clearly manifested in the landscape. The chronological horizon was identified using radiocarbon dating to 777 to 991 AD. This stronghold would be then inhabited by the Baltic Prussians. The next group is barrows. In May 2018, as many as 16 potential archaeological sites were determined. In the surveyed area, we recorded 9 barrows in total, which are interpreted as barrows dated to early Iron Age and linked to the people of West Balt Barrows culture. The largest ones are up to 1 meter tall, with diameter up to the 15 meter long. About 470 meters north of the defensive settlement, Strużyna 24, two barrows were examined, in which historical material was found, dated probably to Halstatt D and linked to the culture of West Balt Barrow culture, which was profoundly influenced by the Pomerian culture. This had the form of stone earth mounds with a stone chest embedded and into undisturbed soil below and surrounded with a circle of stones that enclosed the chamber and outlined the edge of the mounds. In the very same way, one can interpret result of non-invasive investigation using a gradientometer. Measurements were taken in parallel manner in a 10 meter by a 10 meter excavation grid. On the magnetic map, a structure with a circle-like layout can be observed with numerous anomalies in the center. Two large assemblages in the center are most likely a relic of modern treasure hunters' excavation. Okay, the next one. It's perhaps Field's remains. Trace of former land cultivation were already mentioned in the description of the defensive settlement Strużyna 24, where characteristics of the object form as a result of plowing were encountered, estimated at about 14th to 15th century. In the surveyed area, more fields of this sort were distinguished, oftentimes better preserved. In such cases, ridges form as a result of plowing are wider and taller, which can translate into a longer period during which this type of field was used. The greatest recorded width of a ridge is 7 meters. The next group was former farm dwellings. Despite Strużyna and its helmet Stabuniki never developed enough to gain the next administrative level, changes in their internal planning can be spotted in the present-day landscape. This is likely due to the fact that since about mid-16th century, Strużyna village was a fief owned by the Don family. It was on their initiative the manor buildings were erected in Strużyna and Stabuniki, evidence in source back in 1850. So maybe time for conclusions. The analysis of landscape element conducted based on historical sources and DTM data with the support of archaeological research findings allowed the history of the discussed microregion to be reconstructed. This is significant because each of these of the discussed sites is located in a forest area. In this case, the forest served as a safeguard protection, the historical landscape which allowed to be present until modern day. In area adjacent to Strużyna, where forests are gradually cut down due to agricultural reasons and because of the developing infrastructure, conducting such a reconstruction work is not possible, particularly given the highly perishable elements such as all traces of soil cultivation. Thank you.